Over the past few months, I've been working on this video as a follow-up to user comments on a previous video on if it's possible to cast Obsidian. This proved to be a major challenge that took 6 attempts, broke multiple crucibles, and 2 different kilns. But I didn't want to stop until I finally had success at casting Obsidian.
Previously, I made Obsidian Blade by napping, which is kind of the Stone Age technology, but a lot of people wanted to see me try and do actual casting with Obsidian, which is something that's pretty difficult because actual obsidian doesn't melt around over 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit, which is something that's very hard to achieve. So while looking for this, I realized that you can actually cast glass using sand in a similar method that I use for the aluminum. But because I can't melt the actual obsidian, I need to grind it up into small little particles, mix it with a flux, and then melt it. And hopefully then I can cast it into some form of knife.
Obsidian is largely made of silica, like regular glass, but also has an unknown mixture of other impurities in it as well that can make its melting point difficult to work with. Melting straight obsidian is potentially possible, but would likely result in a very thick, viscous substance that'd be hard to work with, especially to cast. My early attempts at glassmaking also had a fair amount of impurities, which made it really difficult to work with. So, the solution to this is flux, which is adding chemicals with lower melting points that make the entire solution melt easier and be fluid enough to cast.
So the thing with napping is that when you fracture it, you're able to create potentially razor thin blades that are a molecule thick. You can't quite reach that same sharpness by just sharpening glass itself, but you should be able to get something close. And it's also probably gonna be pretty brittle, as even this is brittle itself and it has wood reinforcing and holding it. So let's give it a shot. First up is grinding the obsidian, melting it down, and see if this is even feasible.
I used a ball mill to grind it to a fine powder in a liquid solution, which I then need to boil off. One of the biggest pains is getting a crucible that's just big enough to hold a large enough volume, but still fits inside the rather small kiln. As it heats, the obsidian and flux tend to boil over some, and unfortunately, in the smaller crucibles, nearly everything spilled out. For this first test, it looked like the obsidian and flux may have separated, which means this might not be feasible. Also, enough spilled out and burned through the insulation until it broke the kiln's coil, making the kiln unusable. Next, I tried a larger batch using a more flexibly designed kiln that I could scale up to fit a larger crucible.
I suck at this. Melt it all the way through.
For an initial small test knife, I carved a model out of styrofoam and then packed it into the sand. Once poured, the hot glass will burn out the styrofoam and fill in its place. Like regular glass, if my cast obsidian cools too rapidly, it'll fracture and shatter. So I took a note from the compound we used when we made glass with Grant last year and picked up a bag of vermiculite, which can act as an insulator to allow the glass to slowly cool.
Let's give this a shot.
Unfortunately, that wasn't enough, and it still ended up shattering. But the most interesting result was that the remelted obsidian turned out fairly transparent, with just a slight amber color. This is likely due to the flux, which probably added to the transparency, but this also might be related to how this glass is formed versus the original obsidian. Which raises an interesting question on if this compound could even be considered obsidian anymore. Regrinding this glass, I started a new batch. But this time, assuming it got more clear because of the flux, I thought I'd attempt to counteract it by adding some new impurities back in. Specifically, I added in some metals that are often used in glassmaking to dye glass black, nickel and chromium, which gave it a nice dark color, very similar to what it started with. Now to cast it.
Usually she just lays in the grass and eats it. So I'm gonna try and cast this toy Roman sword in obsidian. But I don't want the handle to be obsidian, so I'm gonna cut that off.
Unfortunately, by the time it came to pour it, my crucible had cracked. And the majority of the obsidian had leaked out. While I reset again for another attempt, I was curious to do another experiment to see what would happen if you tried to melt just straight rocks of obsidian. This resulted in an interesting formation of a foamy mess, likely caused by off-gassing of compounds like water that had previously been trapped in the obsidian. The semi-molted obsidian adhered to the crucibles as well as the sides of the kiln, which unfortunately caused this kiln to break as well. But in the interim, I had fixed the first kiln and gotten a better fitting crucible, so let's keep going. Collecting as much of the previous attempt as I could, plus adding some more crushed obsidian, and some more flux, I'm ready to go again. This time with a very promising pour.
Moment of truth, see if the sword is in one piece. I've had mixed results so far with the vermiculite. Some things are still shattering in it, some things not. Let's see what we got.
Dreams. Shattered dreams.
Refusing to give up, I brought my setup to a glassmaking studio, Fosai, where I could throw my final result into their annealing chamber and not risk it shattering. Okay,
So got a weird reaction in the last attempt where it got really bubbly when we poured it. Not sure exactly why. There might have been some cracks that formed when I transported the mold, or there might have just been more humidity in the air that made it damp and caused a reaction. I'd like to polish this and it'd probably break up if I tried to grind it and shine it up. So we're gonna go over there, give it one more shot, do it the right way. Previously I added a little bit of a tang to attach a handle to it easier, but that's kind of flimsy. So I'm a little worried how well that'll hold up. So I think I'm just gonna do the whole thing obsidian. So I'm just super gluing the handle back on, I'll sand cast it once more, and hopefully we'll finally have the obsidian sword. Not very strong. Working with Fosai, I learned how sandcasting for glass is done a slightly different way. Instead of packing the sand tightly around the mold, you lightly place a mold into the sand and pack it only along the edge. The idea is to allow the air to escape through the sand so it doesn't bubble up through the glass like it did last time. Then they also torch the sand to leave a fine layer of carbon on top so the glass can better release from it. So after six attempts, I finally managed to cast a full obsidian blade. Unfortunately, in the annealing process, it got a little cracked and probably can't polish it off and put a nice edge on it, unfortunately. It took quite a bit of flux in order to make it castable, which made it a bit difficult to actually temper. It's kind of messed up the whole annealing and made it a bit weaker. So it's more ceremonial at this point. Despite all the mythology around obsidian, it's really fragile, it's just glass, and So putting through a whole different process than how the obsidian originally formed, which is evident when it became pretty transparent at one point. And then I had to add the additional dyes in order to turn it back into black. So it's kind of debatable if this is obsidian, but it is definitely made from obsidian. And took a lot of attempts, so I finally made it. So this took six attempts and broke two crucibles and two kilns. Just fixed this guy, and last time this crucible cracked, it leaked the obsidian all over it and eroded and did a ton of damage. Fortunately, it's still working at this point, but don't want to push my luck too much. So, as much as I enjoy making unprofitable videos, I think I'm gonna call it at this point, say it's complete. So now that I've cast the glass, next I'm gonna move on to a different mineral and actually try and do actual metals with some copper and make bronze. So do that in a while. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to subscribe and check out other content we have covering a wide variety of topics. Also, if you've enjoyed these series, consider supporting us on Patreon. We are largely a fan-funded channel and depend on the support of our viewers in order to keep our series going. Thanks for watching.